Good evening. We asked the question last night. We're going to ask it again. Just out of curiosity, how many of you were at Phoenix Symphony Hall in 1974 for the Phoenix concerts? Anybody? Oh, we can't see your hand. I can't see your hand. Oh, really? That's... If you're wearing the same clothes, it's kind of weird. Kick it off with a little Wheatfield Lady.
Clockwork run, hey, Concerts from 50 years ago. And the first is our special guest, going to be gracing us with some beautiful steel guitar, Mr. Dan Dugmore. The man, the myth, the legend. We're now going to play the shortest song on the Phoenix Concerts record, okay?
Are we ready?
Oh, you can't look back when you're moving on. No, you can't look back when you gotta go and sing your song.
Where did they go? All of the good that we used to know.
What time ago?
I love the woman. I love the woman in the man show.
But you can't look back. We just woke him up.
Good morning, everyone. Valley forged long ago, nation born in snow. Call it ours, we carved our names in stone. And if that is all we own, memories in stone. You think it's time that we make some of our own? Roll away, roll away, roll, roll away the stone, roll away, roll away. People America, roll away the stone you built.
Okay, so this next song is one that John wrote with the intention that it would one day be recorded by Elvis Presley. And he believes that it got as far as being kind of a warm-up tune for Elvis in the dressing room before he came out. Elvis always planned to put it on the record, but he ended up passing away. But John never gave up hope. Nor do we.
So, who's ready?
One, two, three. Thank you.
need for you, believe it. Wish you were born a curse to lose. So why not go on treating it? Take anyone you choose.
Side of the road, you see a little figure, suitcase by your side, and a sign that reads simply, please. You fishtail across four lanes of highway. Coming to a halt, you give it your best Robert Redford. Hey, honey, where you going? Seattle, mister, where are you going? Well, hell, I was going to the store for cigarettes, but I'll go to Seattle if you want.
I can't hold it on the road when you're sitting right beside me and I'm drunk out of my mind merely from the fact that you are here. And I have not been known as the same as San Joaquin, and I'd just as soon right now pull on over to the side of the road and show you what I mean. Hands on my collar,
let's say we take the big horse out for a run. What do you say?
Settle up.
We're here.
Phoenix Concerts, and we're going to bring out the second one. And this is our very special guest and our den mother and John's muse and inspiration. Please welcome Buffy Ford Stewart.
But these guys do such a great job. And the John Stewart Band, love him. Dan Dugmore, God bless this guy. Woo! Yeah. We're the only ones who were here 50 years ago. Yeah. And Dan, you know, John discovered Dan and Mary, his beautiful wife who's in the audience. Right, Dan?
Yes.
And then Linda Ronstadt stole him away from us, but that's okay. We have him back tonight.
Is she still stealing musicians?
I don't know. I mean, Russ Kunkel was stolen. All the people that John discovered were stolen because he knew the greatest got them.
Buffy, she never stole me. I'm just saying, he kind of discovered me.
Well, he discovered all of you.
Okay.
He discovered this band, I mean, which is the most incredible band on earth. Yeah. And we have some wonderful people in the audience today. Actually, John Stanley, my stepchildren, who are like my babies, are in the audience, Michael, Jeremy, and Amy. Michael is doing the sound.
Yeah, Michael.
And God bless Joel, who has the monitors just right. Yeah. So anyway, we're ready.
So we're gonna do the last campaign trilogy, though.
Yeah, okay, yeah. You know, John and I are so lucky to be in 1968, campaigning with Bobby Kennedy. And he was our hero and our good friend. And when he asked us to be the troubadours on his campaign, we were just so excited. We were in the middle of recording Signals Through the Glass, but that meant nothing. We were just going to be with Bobby. And we were on the plane and we were whisked off and taken to the rallies quickly, and we'd sing every song we knew, and John would write songs on the dime, and until Bobby arrived, and then the crowds would just cheer, and being with Bobby was just the most incredible experience. And Chuck grew up with all the Kennedys, and he knows too how incredible Bobby was, and we were so lucky to be invited up to his room every night after the campaign to have chocolate ice cream with chocolate syrup. And we'd always talk about the day, never relax. It was always about the people, about the day. And Bobby, to me, was like a humanitarian, never like a politician, because he loved everyone, every single person. And I'll never forget one time, we had just left an Indian tribe, and where they were talking about some of the orphans that were being taken away, the Indian orphans. And we were up in the room with Bobby, and John said, "Bobby, who's responsible for all those orphan Indians?" Bobby looked down, looked up, and said, you are responsible." That stuck with me. Because we are all responsible for everything that has happened, that is happening, and everything that will happen. Our voice is important, and what do we have to do about that? We have to vote!
There was more than India, there was more than South Dakota, there was more than California. It was more than Oregon. It was a race against time. It was always on our minds. And he died on the road. We were tired. We were hungry. We were living out of a dream. For all the forgotten people, never heard and never seen. There would come the time, for a moment they would shine, and we'd die on the road. Truly as the sun, truly as the rain, truly I believe that it was the last campaign.
is more than a child to hold you. It is more than heaven for you. It was more than all we could. It was the greatest time. It was always on our minds, and he died.
And how will we ride?
truly as the rain. Truly I believe that it was the last campaign.
What inspired it was our town. We loved that play, and by Thornton Wilder. Are you familiar with the play, Our Town? How we sometimes forget to notice the little things in life that are more important than the big things that we think are so important. And the little things in life, you know, when Emily died in childbirth and came back and realized that everybody was just browsing through time, but not realizing and understanding and loving life. So John wrote this song.
Thank you.
Cody sang to me, and I could see Montana in his eyes. I could see Montana in his eyes. Cody's hair's long, dirty as the rivers of LA. Cody's mind's gone, he never knows just what he's going to say. No, he never knows just what he's going to say.
End of
for back porch afternoon.
Moist chocolate cake.
instruments don't hit holes.
This is actually the perfect setup for this next song. Really.
Carefully played.
Good people, you know what I'm talking about. Right. You know what I mean? This is an important deal right now, folks, because these songs, you know, they just keep me thinking about the country we live in and how we all share it together and how I grew up with neighbors and, you know, you agree with some of them, you don't agree with all of them, but we all got along, we made it work, you know, because that was how, that was the way to be. And so many of these songs just keep that spirit alive, I think. So we don't ever want to forget that. And that's kind of what I think about when I do this whole thing here. Because there was a story in the San Francisco Chronicle. And of course I forgot to sing. But it was about a lady who lived in the good old days, when the century was born and the century had died. And about these good old days, the old lady replied, why, they were just a lot of people doing the best they could. Just a lot of people doing the best they could. And then the lady said that they did it pretty up and walking good. They were men who stood gates back there. And here they come. E.H. Stewart in the wagon right behind.
Copy of this album. It's going to be for sale out. No, it's not. This is a cool double album. I just thought it'd be a good time to give a huge shout out to the musicians and vocalists who played on it back in 74 at Phoenix Symphony Hall. So, of course, you have John Stewart on vocals, electric and acoustic guitars. Yeah. You have Arnie Moore on bass. Arnie, good old Arnie. Jonathan Douglas on organ, congas, and piano. He's very busy that night. Lauren Newkirk on piano and organ. Busy, but not quite as busy. Jim Gordon on drums. Michael Stewart, John's brother, on rhythm guitar. Michael was an incredibly talented person. He founded the band We Five.
Woke up this morning.
Oh, well, that was a song. No, no, killer song. I love that song with the 12-string electric on it. And he also produced Billy Joel's Piano Man. And
he was a big guy.
Yeah, he certainly was. And then, oh, look here, Dan Dugmore on pedal steel and electric. And vocals, we had additional vocals, Mike Settle, Denny Brooks, Buffy Ford Stewart. And it was all produced by Nick Vinay.
Oh, Nick, what a producer. Yeah.
Wow. Anyway.
Hey?
That might be all I have. No, you know what? That weird coincidence did kick in because it says on the inside of the album it was recorded in March of 1974, but it didn't have the dates. And after the MIM kind of sorted out their schedule and we said, okay, it ended up being tonight and tomorrow night, the 22nd and 23rd of March. Total coincidence, which it turns out that was when this album was recorded, the exact two nights.
Wow.
Then I went on the Google net and I found out that it was also a Friday and Saturday night back in 1974.
Wow.
Oh, now you're impressed.
Thank you, Min. I love this museum. It's beautiful.
Dave, does anybody have a 9-volt battery? Cross it!
Tracks before us, keeping it down. Dennis the D-Man Kettle on drum. Pan holding down the bottle while he's lifting up the earth. That rock star daddy dancing, Danny Barry.
We're just going to play a few more songs, if that's okay with you. This is like, he played John like he was Bruce Springsteen, and so that's why we're going to go along tonight. We're going to do a Bruce Springsteen type set here, hope you don't mind. But he played it and made John big in Phoenix. So 50 years later, about 49 years later, a friend now named Steve Tiller calls me up and says, you guys need to do a 50th anniversary of that concert. And so he started brainstorming and eventually came up to, well, the MEM would be the perfect place to do it. So Steve called Andrew and Andrew didn't know what he was talking about. And Andrew called me and we talked and Andrew, thank you very much, took a chance and we played here for two nights. So let's give it up for Andrew. And the staff here is amazing. From Joel to Jesse, the hotel, we're getting the hotels for us, the artist coordinator, and Belle out there on the merch and stuff. They couldn't be nicer. So please give a round of applause for these great people here. All the volunteers. I was out to guest services about 20 times, got my 10,000 steps in, and Heaven out there helped me out. So that was it. Yeah. But a few more thank yous. T-shirts. We have T-shirts. Okay. We kept it in house. My sister designed the T-shirts. So thank you, Laura. And Ann for helping out backstage. Thank you very much.
Oh, Ann, I love you, Ann.
And most of all, thank all of you for coming.
So, yes.
Thank you very much. So, John, what do you say we play a few of the greatest hits?
Well, let's do this top 10 hit right here. Oh, wait a minute. You know what? The medication kicked in. I skipped a song. I hate everything I stand for. I really do. Jeez. All right, well. How about this song instead, then? Actually a number one song for Roseanne Cash, so we're going up.
Runaway Train, yeah.
Wow.
God, I had this song. Had a tune for the last one, I'm kidding. Okay, here we go.
I'm worried about you.
time. Dynamite too. Do a number one song, Runaway Train. Thank you.
didn't like turned into the biggest friggin' hit.
Kind of liked it, right?
Huh?
Kind of.
No, he didn't like it. I was with him when he wrote it. No, he didn't like it. The record company said, give me a hit. I said, brother, you want a hit? No, okay, I'll give you a hit. He gave him a hit, yeah.
That's what they said to Springsteen and he wrote Dancing in the Dark.
It's true.
Really? Yeah.
Do you want to say anything about If You Should Remember Me, or should we hit it?
Oh, sure, I have a lot to say, but you don't let me say it.
Strict time limit, folks.
No, it's because timing, yeah. Otherwise, I'd tell a lot of stories. But, yeah, I mean, I will say a little bit about John, who is here tonight. I mean, I can feel him, can't you? John is everywhere. And I feel him here, especially tonight. And I also wanted to say Henry, the most famous photographer in the universe, is here. And yeah, Henry Gilks. And Hen, I know you want to come up when we sing Daydream Believer, and you can. Is that okay, Chuck?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, okay, yeah. And so. Yeah, and you all know that when John left to go to heaven, he was suffering from Alzheimer's, which, are you laughing?
No.
No, it wasn't fun for him or for anybody. But anyway, so in the last days of his life, he was sitting at the kitchen table and I had a CD on, Walk on the Moon, and he said, I wrote that, didn't I? I said, yeah, you sure did. One of your best, I think. He said, yeah, I wrote that. Do you want to dance? I said, yeah, I do. So we danced in the kitchen to Walk on the Moon. So sweet. Anyway, this is a song that you should remember me. Thank you. story after that. After Johnny went to heaven, I was in Coronado, and I was looking for a cake for his daughter's birthday. He died almost on her birthday. And a bird flew in this bakery that was, there's no way a bird could fly in and fly out, but it came in and flew around my head, did a U-turn, and flew out the window, just right out the door. And who I was with, this friend, she said, "Buffy, that was John." I said, "I know." And everyone else said, "Was that your bird?" And I said, "No, that was my husband."
So now we have Henry Dilts up to help us sing this song. It was a huge hit for the Monkees. Oh, wrong Monkees song. Sorry. Construction crew.